first I am doing this practical. So first I have to take one matrix. So for that I am writing include stdio dot h int main, then return 0. Here I can write int a of, I am taking 3x3 matrix, so that's why I am taking a of 3, and I am storing its result to b, so that's why I am taking b 3 of 3, so b is the resultant matrix. Now I have to take this value from user, so I am telling user enter the matrix a, right? And here after I am taking for loop. Inside for loop I am taking I equal to 0, I is less than 3, I plus plus. Here I am going to take values, say I am going to print f, say a of percentage d, here percentage d equal to, and after every I am going to print a new line, space comma, and here scanf, it will be like percentage d, and here it will be and a of I comma j. So this is incorrect because I have not taken j, so I have to take value of another loop, that is j, because we know that for two dimensional arrays we have to take nested loop. So here it will be something like this. Okay, now let me copy this and paste it over here, right? So I have pasted it over here. Now user will be able to enter some values. Now how can I get b? For getting b I have to iteratively assign the values, right? How I can assign the values? Instead of this I am doing b of I comma j equal to a of j comma I. So I am assigning values in this way, right? After this, after the assignments, I am going to print the matrix p. So here I am writing printf slash n matrix d is, and then I am going to write a loop. Inside this loop I am going to print matrix. So printf percentage d, here it will be percentage d, then tab, so getting more space, than b of ij. Some students used to print a of ji, so which is partially correct, but it is good if you are assigning this value, right? So I am printing b of ij over here, and after each new row I am going to print it in new line, right? So let me just save this program as matrix. If I compile this program and run it, it will throw me an error because I have not declared I and j. So let me just declare it and save it and compile it and run it. No semicolon. Do a semicolon, save it, compile it and run it. Another no semicolon, so many mistakes are there, but you know that how to solve these mistakes, right? So now it is compiled successfully. Now I can enter value of, now it is showing me some garbage value. Why? Because here for percentage d I have not written anything, that's why it is showing me garbage value of I and j. So let me write I comma j over here if there any mistake doesn't seem to. So now save the program, compile it and run it. So enter 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I hope it looks like 1, 4, 7 first. So it is taking 1, 4, 7 first. This is how it is printing. But let me do it in some good manner. So after this I am writing slash n. Let me save this program again, compile it and run it. If I am entering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So you can see it is printed in transposed manner, right? So transpose of A is B, and this is how it can be printed. So this is all about writing a program to find transpose of a given matrix. So this program we have successfully completed, right? So this program is successfully completed. So let me erase this. So in the next video, I am going to tell you that how you can find the multiplication of two matrices. So stay tuned with me. I hope you enjoy this class and understand the concepts. If you have any doubt, you can comment below the comment section. See you in the next class. Thank you so much.